In earlier videos, we have discussed DNA replication in prokaryotes. Now in this video, we will learn about the initiation of DNA replication in eukaryotes. Origin of replication in yeast is known as autonomously replicating sequence or ARS, which includes a consensus sequence, A domain, and additional elements. As cells enter the G1 phase of the cell cycle, the origin recognition complex or ORC bound to the ATP comes and binds to the ARS region. Now this ORC recruits ATP-bound helicase loading protein CDC6. Next, two copies of hexamer mini-chromosome maintenance protein complex or MCM227 complex attach alongside another helicase loading protein CDT1. This makes the whole complex unstable and this triggers ATP hydrolysis by CDC6. This results in the MCM complex encircling the double-stranded DNA and the release of CDC6 and CDT1 from the origin. Here, the MCM complex functions as helicase. During the G1 phase, only the unwinding of DNA occurs. As the cell enters the S phase of the cell cycle, initiation of replication starts. This starts with the activation of two protein kinases, cyclin-dependent kinase or CDK and DBA4-dependent kinase or DDK. Once activated, DDK phosphorylates the MCM227 complex, whereas CDK phosphorylates two other replication proteins, SLD2 and SLD3. Phosphorylated SLD2 and SLD3 then bind to the DPB11 and they altogether attach to the origin complex. This facilitates the binding of helicase activating proteins CDC45 and GINS to the complex. Now the CDC45 and GINS form a stable complex with the MCM227 helicase, which is called as CMG complex. This complex dramatically activates MCM227 helicase activity. Before unwinding, DNA polymerase epsilon is recruited to the helicase at both the strands. After the formation of this complex, SLD2, SLD3 and DPB11 are released and the unwinding of DNA strands starts. As the DNA unwinds, DNA polymerase alpha along with the primase and DNA polymerase delta are recruited on both the strands. And after that, the DNA elongation begins.